Get ready to match the stars. Avery Schreiber. Brett Summers. Gary Burghoff. Phyllis Newman. Richard Dawson. And Patti Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74.
Thank you, Johnny Olson, and dear friends and gentle hearts.
Your pants don't match your jacket and your vest.
My pants don't match my jacket or my vest.
Yeah.
Well, I can't afford a whole thing to buy at one time. That's the way it is.
You look cute anyway.
Thanks, cutie. Okay. Everybody okay?
Sure.
Are you all right, Avery?
Sure.
Good. Are we traumatizing you?
No, not at all anymore.
Why do you ask?
Well, it's his, you know, first
he
week on the show.
He always does his hair like
How
that.
Do you feel about your first
I
week
I feel
here?
Terrific. They're not as mean as they look at home, folks. Yeah, I really don't.
All right, what do you say we say hello to the player? the two girls here.
She must be your wife.
Gloria and Mason, there she is. Hi, Gloria.
Hi, Gloria.
Listen, Marc Breslow, would it be possible to do a split screen with Gloria Mason and
Patti Deutsch?
The same thing? Is that possible? Can you do split screen on the show while I look at the monitor and
Does
see?
They look alike?
Well, just, I just...
They... We've never tried that.
Well, let's try it. It'll just
what
take a
nice
second.
Nice compliment.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well,
Thank
I just want to see you two ladies side by side.
The bangs.
Your faces side by side. They both have
weird.
The same bangs. They both have pretty smiles and pretty
They're
eyes.
Very nice.
There they are.
You know.
Why, they
smile,
do
okay.
look. Oh. No, they look out. They do. Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah, the technical director ought to get a hand because
Excuse
we do
me.
These spontaneous things on the spur of the moment.
Right.
Yes.
Could I have a split screen with Richard Dawson to show how much we look alike?
Only if you shave first. All right, now listen.
Oh,
this
so
lady
nice.
Has won $100. She's won her first game, and she's going to have a go at the big money super match here and have a go at over $5,000. We'll do that right after we pass along this message to you.
Oh, okay.
Oh, here we are. I know I'm only kidding. Are you ready, Gloria?
I'm ready.
Okay, now, you know how this goes. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, Patty's ready, too. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Morning blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500. Bing, if you match it. And the second most frequent response worth $250. And the third, $100. Which celebrities would you like a hand from?
Avery.
What do you do with that? Morning blank. How do you fill that blank in, Avery?
I said after.
Morning after. Okay, there's one. They like that one. Now, another one.
Patty? Sickness.
Oh, Patty, I can't tell me.
What an expected call.
Patty, you so said nice. It as if you've had it. But you don't have any children, do you?
I've had it. She's got it.
I have a dachshund, though.
Oh, you have a dachshund. I see. One more.
She was sick.
Richard.
And Richard.
Morning Glory.
Morning Glory.
Oh, that's it.
Now, Gloria, it's up to you to make a decision. You may use one of those or give us one of your own.
I think I'm going to go along with Richard and say Morning Glory because that's what I first thought of, too.
You thought of Morning Glory right off the bat.
Yes,
and you hope that's going to be up there under the $500 spot. All right, we'll find out if it is right now. But we got to start down at the bottom and take a look first at the $100 response. Morning sickness. There's Patty's answer. Okay, that may be a good sign. And I've never heard of sickness being a good sign before. Here we go. Looking for Morning Glory. May we see the $250 response.
Glory! Congratulations.
What do you think is under there, the big one there? After?
Morning Star.
Morning Star.
Morning Dew? No.
Morning Dew?
No.
All right. Here we go with a $500 response.
Oh, that's Mountain Dew.
Morning After. Avery!
Yeah. Well, you know, beginner's luck.
But did you hear his other one? His other choice was Morning Mother.
He just left home last week. 46 years old.
Now, Gloria, you've got $250. You're going to play for $2,500. To collect, you've got to match one of them head-to-head, and this will have to be an exact match, and it's time for you to name that person now.
Richard.
Okay. You face me, if you would, please. Here's the $2,500 question. Blank jam. J-A-M. Blank jam. Finished. Now we find out from this lady what answer she has in her mind that she thinks will match his. Blank jam. What do you say to that?
Strawberry jam.
You say strawberry jam? You're getting half-hearted applause from the audience, but they can be wrong sometimes, so don't pay any attention to them. Pay attention to Richard Dawson, because he's going to hold his card. What's that?
They're not wrong this time.
They're not.
Traffic jam.
Traffic jam is an excellent answer. Strawberry jam is a little marmalade. Oh, he has strawberry up there.
I'd like to show you what did you Schreiber
have?
Has there.
No, I didn't have anything worth it.
Toe jam.
Now, you've still got your $350 here, and you're still the champ, and you're going to meet another player right now, so let's bring on that player. Here comes Joy Speck. You, Joy, you know Gloria. And Joy Speck will now tell us her life story in 8 seconds.
Well, I'm married.
You're married?
Yes.
Okay, it was a short wedding, wasn't it? Sir?
I have a daughter, Wendy Kay, who's 2 and a half, and I work part-time in Dime a Bar.
You work part-time?
Yes.
You have beautiful brown eyes.
Oh, thank you.
Doesn't she have beautiful brown eyes?
Beautiful brown eyes.
Right.
The right one.
We're only talking about that breakfast.
She has pretty dimples, too, doesn't she?
Very nice dimples.
Lovely dimples.
I'd get on with it before you get in trouble.
All right. We're ready to have a go at it. If you are, good luck to both ladies. Please make a selection.
A, please.
A. Here we go. Okay.
What are you laughing at?
Beautiful brown eyes. Beautiful brown.
She's over 50.
All right. Now, one time on this program, some time ago, Patti Deutsch did a terrific imitation of Howard Cosell. And she's going to do it again.
How did she get so lucky?
All right. Okay. Mrs. Howard Cosell said...
Yes. I met my husband Howard at a big Hollywood premiere, wherein I spotted my husband-to-be blanking his own hand.
You tell him, Howard. Blanking his own hand.
Blanking his own what?
His own hand.
Could you read it again, please?
Yeah, read it again.
I met my husband Howard...
Wait a minute.
...at a big Hollywood premiere. Wherein I spotted my husband-to-be blanking his own hand.
Oh!
I love it when you get cross with it.
All right. Okay. So just put this slot in the card in the slot.
I haven't finished it yet.
Oh, all right.
It hasn't even started. It's so depressing. Charles,
listen.
Darling, please come home. All is forgiven.
Your days at the Art Students League are over. Put the card in a slot. It's fancy enough.
I'm not drawing anything. This is drawn before the show. I'm trying to think of an answer.
Oh, I see. I met my husband Howard at a big Hollywood premiere wherein I spotted my husband-to-be blanking his own hand. And Howard Cosell is talking. Do you know who Howard Cosell is?
All right, just a minute.
People think of him as kind of an...
former attorney at law.
I know who Howard Cosell is.
Yes, and you know what his reputation is in the industry and all that? No, he wasn't. Okay, now we come over here to Joyce Beck. Mrs. Howard Cosell, you know who Howard Cosell
is. Yes, I know him.
I met my husband Howard at a big Hollywood premiere wherein I spotted my husband-to-be blanking his own hand.
Kissing?
Kissing his own hand. Good answer. Kissing his own hand.
That's nice.
Kissing his own hand.
Kissing
that's
his own wonderful hand.
I said kissing his own hand.
Wonderful answer. See? Howard Cosell has that kind of reputation for being sort of, you know, fond of himself.
Well, why not? That's the way he is.
That's right.
Is he true he buys his rugs at Newbury's? It certainly looks that way, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I said kissing.
Kissing. That's cool for you, Joy. Gary, what did you say?
Well, there's another kind of hand, and I said he was giving himself his own hand. Oh, like applause. So I said applauding.
Applauding his own hand. we come down here to Phyllis Newman. I spotted my husband-to-be blanking his own hand.
Well, I had a visual picture. I don't know what other kind of picture you could have of him shaking his own hand.
Shaking his own hand.
That's a nice answer. Yeah.
No, he would
like
be doing
I
that.
This was nobody
else would
shake his hand.
Right, okay.
I like kissing.
And you, boy, we're sure making a lot of friends of Howard Cosell here.
Who cares? We're not in football or baseball.
That's
what
right.
can he do to us?
Well, he can sue us because he's a lawyer.
Oh, no, he's good. He's good.
What do you say?
The way our career's going, we might end up in football. Well, I had an audio picture.
Yeah.
And I said, shake it.
All right, Patti Deutsch, who looks like Gloria Mason.
Yes.
You have a card there with an answer
yes,
on it.
Yes, I said that Howard was announcing his own hand.
Announcing his own hand.
Took him to a poker game.
Yeah. Yes.
It's my hand.
So that's two for you, Joy. Your question coming up, but right now we got a message for you. Pay attention now. Hello there. Here we go on our merry way. Now, you've had your question, you've matched two celebrities, and now it's your turn. Round one, everybody plays. The jungle doctor said, these natives are really mean. I get nervous every time I ask a patient to blank. The jungle doctor said, these natives are really mean. I get nervous every time I ask a patient to blank.
A jungle doctor?
A jungle doctor is speaking.
Was it Schweitzer?
Albert Schweitzer?
Not with that accent.
No. All right. In the nick of time. All right, these two bodies are ready. Her body is ready, but left her mind home.
San Francisco.
You don't know.
Is your body ready?
Let me ask you one question. Did she ever get out of the jungle?
Okay,
can
set.
I change?
Well, if you can do it quickly.
Okay.
All right, quickly.
Okay.
All right. She changed her mind last minute. Gloria Mason. The jungle doctor said these natives are really mean. I get nervous every time I ask a patient to...
open his mouth.
Open his mouth. Talk. Yeah. Say ah. Okay. Now don't boo her. She's the champ. Just leave her alone.
Is that a good answer?
Well, sure.
Yeah, sure, you bangy, but I don't
understand. You know, he's in the middle of the jungle, and he gets nervous every time he says, open, you know, all
open
that.
Open your mouth.
Yeah, yeah. Open wide.
Makes the natives nervous.
Yeah, they could eat the doctor.
I thought they'd be much more nervous if he said, cough.
Cough. No match there.
Nobody likes that either. Mm-hmm.
No, that'd make me nervous, but not them then. What do you say?
Well, honey, I have my degree, as we all know. I said leave a specimen.
I see. All right. Moving right along to Gary Burghoff.
Do you have any air sick bags?
No.
Wait till you hear mine. I said cough, too.
Cough. Okay. Taking a couple of coughs there.
How would she know cough?
Yes. Right. What do you say, Phyllis?
Mine is a long explanation. Do you have time?
Yeah.
First, I thought the natives were naked so that the doctor would, they would get nervous if he said to dress. Do you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But then I crossed out dress, and then I said to say ugh.
Say ugh.
But that's like opening your mouth. Say ah, say ugh. Isn't that a match?
Yeah, that
yes,
is a match.
Yes, it is. You see?
By Jones, you talked him into it. Yes.
But you do get the picture.
Yes, say
okay.
ugh.
Say
because
ugh.
You couldn't say ah. You
that's
only
right.
say ah in
oh,
Boston.
That's right.
Right.
That's right.
You got the picture on that. Would you read the question, please?
All right, anything you say, dear. I get nervous every time I ask a patient to...
bend over. Here's my plan.
Well, the doctor wasn't too sure of himself. I see that. What do you say?
I just wanted understood that I did not know this answer would follow that answer.
Okay.
Open wide.
Okay.
That's a match.
All right.
That's a match.
Well, the score is now 2-2.
We better make a lot of things perfectly clear.
Just in the nick of time, we've got a commercial, and this is it. Go to black. Right. Here we go. Round two coming up. Push this button, and the thing slides down after a while, and we got a tie score here. We're going to break the tie. Right, Joy?
Right.
What do you want?
A again, please.
A. Who does not play? Avery and Brett do not play. Everybody else does.
Right.
Condraculous hat.
Yeah.
Condraculous hat.
Yes.
Yeah.
I have not had a wink of sleep since my coffin was eaten by blank. That's what he said.
Say that
again. I have
again.
Not had a wink of sleep since my coffin was eaten by blank.
Eaten?
Eaten by blank. By blank.
By gum.
Do you understand me, Joy?
I grab
you. Don't talk about me. When I'm gone. Okay. Bobby. Everybody is ready. I will read it to you one more time. I have not had a wink of sleep since my coffin was eaten by blank.
Termites.
Termites.
What's here for the bugs? She said termites.
Oh.
Termites is the answer.
And they also eat Christmas trees. Termites, termites.
Oh, he's got termites up there, yeah. Here we go.
What are they, blind?
See, you thought termites is a right answer. It's a good answer there. Termites is a good answer, right?
It's a wonderful answer, so I said the bat. First I said Bela Lugosi, and then I said the bat.
And then it was...
Oh, no, Joe, don't be so mean to me. I'm only trying. You come up here and try it.
Yes, come up here. Everybody go, no, you better not there.
You tell them, fat lady.
Look who's talking.
Yeah. Now, Richard, would you like to carry on?
Have you two queens finished?
Yeah.
Termite.
Termite. Go.
Beavers.
Beavers?
Beavers
don't eat coffins.
How do you know?
They chew on wood.
They certainly do.
How do you know?
Beavers eat wood.
No, they just chop down trees and make dams.
No, you lived in New York too long.
No.
You're not allowed to say that.
Get out of beaver country, Wisconsin.
How many have you got? You got four. You got two. You need two to tie, three to win. Ready? Here we go. Pay attention. Okay. Listen. Lady with the wig, will you pay attention?
She can't help it. She likes me.
He's gone crazy.
Yes, I know.
Well, look where I've been sitting.
When Maid Marian lost the key to the padlock on her chastity belt, Robin Hood knocked the lock off with his blank.
What was the question?
Say it again.
You don't play.
What was the question?
When Maid Marian lost the key to the padlock on her chastity belt, Robin Hood knocked the lock off with his blank.
I got it the first time.
And a girl.
Okay. It's a simple question.
Requiring
a simple answer.
Oh, which Robin Hood is
all
this?
All right. Good.
Really?
All right, yeah. Just think about it now. When Maid Marian lost the key to the padlock,
I heard it.
Robin Hood knocked the lock off with his...
Shh, don't say the answer.
Blank. All right. Now we are ready to call on Gloria for her response. When Maid Marian lost the key to the padlock on her chastity belt, Robin Hood knocked the lock off with his...
Only thing I can think of is arrow.
Arrow.
Is that really all you could think of?
That's
What did you finally think of?
Well, I figured, he's been living out in the forest a long time.
Yeah.
We got through with the termites, things linked up, and I said with his teeth.
Okay. Well, all right. They don't like that answer. You play? Yes, you play.
I play.
Yeah, may we see your response, please?
I would be thrilled to show you my response.
Right.
He knocked it off with his bow and arrow.
There's one for you. You need one more to tie. Gary's.
Teeth.
Knocked it off with his teeth, eh?
Yeah.
I'm sure you don't have an air sick bag. I said arrow.
Arrow, there's the tie score. Now, one more for you, we'll win the game. One more arrow. Richard, do you give this lady an arrow?
No, but I'll give her a couple of dollars.
Maid Marian lost the key to the padlock on her chastity belt. Robin Hood knocked the lock off with his...
Well, I knew Robin Hood very well. He was the man that made Marian. And I wrote bow and arrow.
Bow and arrow. That's a match. You win the game. Come on down.
She's so excited, she forgot to come down. She doesn't know what she's doing there. You stand here for a moment. We've got to say goodbye to Joy Speck. Thank you for being with
us
on Match Game 74. A gift for you. Goodbye, Joy. There she goes. Now this message for you. Pay attention. Hello there. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 74. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production. Yeah.